Limits and Continuity, subtopic 8.1 Limits. The objective for today, find infinite limits. Limits at infinity, when the limits are undefined, and discuss this one. Okay? And, okay, consider limit 1 over x squared as x approaches 0. Okay, table below presents the values. Check the table. Okay, let's see, this is table. The values. Okay, so from the table, we observe that when that one is 1 over x squared, substitute the value. When x approaches 0, okay, from left and from right, and this limit, okay, approaches y value or fx value, approaches the very big number. The very big number. Why? Because the one is from a small number to the big number. We also from small number to the big number. And until we don't know how big is the number, we call that one is infinity. Infinity. Okay, very big number. Okay, graph. The graph is okay. When x approaches 0 from left and right. Okay, so the graph is tends to infinity, positive. Okay, so for this graph, when x approaches 0 from right and from left, okay, the graph is tends to infinity. So limit fx, okay, when x approaches 0 from left, okay, is equal to positive infinity, and limit this function as x approaches 0 from right, okay, and the graph is tends to positive infinity. You can conclude that limit this function as x approaches 0 is undefined. Okay, undefined. We don't know the exact value. Okay, they exist but undefined. Okay, infinite limits. The one-sided infinite limits can be defined similarly. The notation for one-sided infinite limits are limit fx, function fx, as approaches a from left. Okay, equals positive infinity. And, okay, limit function as approaches a from left also goes to negative infinity. Okay, limit this function fx as approaches a from right goes to negative infinity, and limit fx as approaches a from right, it goes to positive infinity. So that one is one-sided limit. Is that either left or right? Okay, so next, infinite limits. Okay, if function fx as approaches a from right is equal to positive infinity, and limit fx, the same function as approaches a from left, okay, equals negative infinity. This one positive infinity, this one negative infinity. Okay, then we can conclude that the limit fx as approaches a, only a, does not exist. Okay, does not exist. So when the limit function, this function as approaches a from right, okay, positive, and limit fx as approaches a from left also positive infinity, then the limit fx as approaches a exists but undefined. We don't know the exact value. Okay, and if limit fx as approaches a from right negative infinity, then the limit fx as approaches a from left equals negative infinity. Okay, then the limit fx as approaches a on a is also undefined. This one equal negative infinity, negative infinity. So the limit fs fs plus a equals negative infinity and undefined. Okay, here for the second one, limit fx, okay, as x approaches a, actually is equal to positive infinity and undefined. That's why we don't know the value. But for this one, it's not equal. Okay, limit on the left, as x approaches a from left, not equal to limit fx as x approaches a from right. So the limit does not exist. Okay. Okay, another criteria of limits. Limit 1 over x power r as x approaches a from positive equal to positive infinity. Okay, the second is limit this one, 1 over x power r as x approaches 0 from left. Negative, yeah, left. Okay, so consider when it becomes negative infinity when the power is odd number. Odd number. Okay, so example, 1 over x cube. Okay, and becomes positive when r is even number. Example, x to the power 4. Okay, then for the first one, when x approaches 0 from right, it's okay. This one is working for both power odd or even power. Okay. Example 1. Given fx equal to 1 over 3 minus x, find limit fx. As x approaches 3 from right, as x approaches 3 from left, right, left, and find limit the whole mean, this one, fx, as x approaches 3. As approaches 3 means that you need to find from left and also from right. Okay. Okay. Find limit 1 over 3 minus x as approaches 3 from left. Okay. And then if you substitute 3 minus 3 from left. Okay, this one actually 1 over 0. Okay, 3 minus 3, 0. But actually 3, okay, from left. 3 from left. This is 3, 0.3, 0.3. Infinity goes to positive infinity. Okay, so this is 4. This is 2. This one is goes to negative infinity. So from left, left means that this number, okay, less than 3, something like 2.999. So 3 minus 2.99 means that the answer is positive. Okay, so this 3 is bigger than this one, this value, but still you need to substitute 3. 3 minus 3, 0. So 0 positive or infinity positive. Okay, try for the on the right hand side. Limit, okay, this function as x approaches 3 from right here. Okay, let's say here, say that 3.01. Okay, then substitute. When you substitute the value, you have to substitute 3, this one 3. Alright, this one. Okay, so now 3 minus 3 actually 0. But this 3 from right, something like 3.01. Okay, so the number is bigger than 3. Okay, something like that. Okay, so 3 minus 3 means that this one bigger than this. This one bigger than this number. So get negative. So it's equal 1 over 0. Okay, infinity, undefined actually. Negative. Okay, so we can conclude that limit 1 over 3 minus x as x approaches 3. Okay, or okay, it implies that before that, implies that limit this one as x approaches 3 from left okay, is not equal limit 1 over 3 minus x as x approaches 3 from right. This one positive infinity. On the this one also negative infinity. Then conclude that therefore limit 1 over 3 minus x as x approaches 3 all, okay, does not exist. It does not exist. Okay? Okay, the graph is like this. When 3 from left, okay, the graph goes to positive infinity. When the event approaches 3 from right, so from left, the graph is tends to negative infinity. Okay, then the limit this function fx does not exist for all. Okay. Example 2. Okay, given this function, okay, find limit. Okay, this one, and also this one on the left, on the right. Let's say here. Okay, limit. Okay, limit. Okay, 1 over x minus 2 squared. As x approaches 2 from right. So the number line, this is 2, 3, 1. Okay, so 2 from right. Let's say here. Okay, number 2.01. Okay, because of positive from right. From right, positive. Then substitute. Okay, 2 minus 2. Okay, square. Actually, 1 over 0 squared. So 2.01 minus 2. Actually positive. Actually you don't have to write positive or negative. Yeah? So the one is positive infinity. Why? Because of this is 2 squared. Yeah? Squared 2. But everything changes to positive. Okay. Check this one. Okay. Limit. Okay. As approaches 2 from left. Is the same function. Square. Okay. Let's say this is 2 from left. Okay, choose one number. Let's say 1.99. Okay, substitute. 2. So you substitute left minus 2 squared. Same like 1.99 minus 2. This what 0, also 0. But that one is negative squared. So you get infinity positive. Okay. So we can conclude actually, therefore, limit this function as x approaches 2, only 2, is equal to positive infinity. Why? Because of the same positive infinity on the right hand side, on the left hand side. Conclude therefore, is undefined. Limit exists to infinity, positive, but undefined. Okay, you just show a solution like this, okay, and also like this. Then conclude is undefined. Example 3. Okay, limit fx as approaches a from right, and limit fx as approaches a from left. Okay. Determine the limit as x approaches a if exists. For okay, this one a given is negative 1. Just substitute negative 1 here. Okay, so find the limit. Okay, for this question, okay, substitute a to negative 1. Okay, say we just sketch number line, negative 1, okay, 0, negative 2, number line to the right, for the greatest number to the right, the least number to the left. Here is negative 1 from right. open on the left hand side, negative 1 from left, eh? Positive, negative. So just one number which is from right. This one 0, 0, 0.1, 0.2, 0.9. So this is negative, okay, 0.999. Let's say this one positive, eh? From right. This is negative 1, 91.1, 91 point something until negative 2. So let's say this one is negative 1, 0, 1. Okay, then continue to the first on the left hand side. Limit negative 1 over x squared minus 1. Okay, as x approaches negative 1 from left. So because of this one, it can be factorized. Okay, try factorize this one, the denominator. Okay, still you need to write down the limit. Okay, negative 1 x minus 1 x plus 1. Okay, then substitute. Okay, substitute. Just substitute. Once you substitute, you need to substitute negative 1. Negative 1 plus 1. Okay, this one negative 1 plus 1 is 0. 0. Okay, so actually up here negative is negative, negative, negative. This one is 0. 0 is, let's say, negative 1 from left. We want to check whether the 0 is positive or negative. Thus, and thus negative or positive. Negative 1 from left is negative 101. Negative 101 plus 1. Is that this one is negative, negative. This is not good, eh? Don't write this one, just for you imagine the value. Okay, and then okay, negative, negative, negative. So answer is negative. Okay, this one also negative 2 times 0, 0. 1 over 0 is infinity. So this one is negative infinity. Okay, proceed to the on the right hand side. Limit negative 1 x squared minus 1 as x approaches negative 1 from right. Okay, and then the next step. Okay, factorize x minus 1 x plus 1. Okay, write down the limit on the left hand side until you substitute the value. Okay, no need to write the limit. Substitute. Okay, negative 1 minus 1, negative 1 plus 1. The problem is this one. Okay, this number and this number lah. Okay, and then is equal to negative 1 over negative 2. Settle. This one confirm 0. Negative 1 from right. Negative 1 from right. So now 1 minus 0.999. 1 is bigger than 1. So this one is just positive. Okay, just imagine. Okay, so negative over negative, positive means that 1 over 0 is infinity, positive. Positive. Okay, so we can conclude that. Okay, change the color. The color. Okay, so limit, okay, negative 1 over x squared minus 1 as x approaches negative 1 only, not left and right. Actually, this one not equal to this, so does not exist. So it's not equal on the left, not equal to on the right. We can conclude that the limit for negative 1 does not exist. Okay, limits at infinity. Okay, if x approaches negative infinity, okay, fx approaches but never could reach the value of m using limit notation, we state that, okay, limit fx, fx, which is negative infinity, is equal to m. Okay, never touch line limit. Just approaches the line. Okay, and then when this limit, okay, limit fx as x approaches tends to positive infinity, go to right, is equal to L. Means that the graph actually never touch line L, just approaches the line. Okay, use the theorem for n positive. For n positive, okay, limit 1 over x power n as approaches positive infinity. Here n is positive, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1 over the big, very big number, let's say 10 something, it approaches 0. 1 over infinity is equal to 0. Okay, when limit this one as approaches negative infinity, also 0. Okay, so 0. Okay, and limit when x power n approaches positive infinity, this one also approaches positive infinity. So when this one, when x tends to negative infinity, okay, you have two cases. Okay, when n is even number, it goes to positive infinity. When n is odd number, it goes to negative infinity. Okay, let's say x to the power 10. Okay, so positive infinity. And this one is, let's say x to the power negative 10. X to the power 9. Okay, so this one is negative. So x is negative value, power 9. So answer is negative. Okay, this one x is negative value, the power even number, so it changes to positive. Okay. Okay, try this. Evaluate the following. Okay, this one substitute 1 over infinity is equal to 0, right? This one also 0 because of 1 over negative infinity. And this is constant. This is x variable. So you cannot substitute the constant. Constant is constant. The permanent value is 8. Okay, no x to substitute. So the answer is 8. Okay, so here, substitute here. Okay, this one is positive. So we get the large number, positive. Okay, then this one negative, substitute power odd number. So got the negative infinity. Okay, so here, substitute, get positive infinity. Because of the coefficient is negative, answer is negative infinity. Okay, so here also substitute, okay, because of the one is even power, it gives positive answer, positive, this one negative, so answer is negative. Okay, and this one, okay, negative infinity substitute, okay, odd power, so get negative. Negative times negative 7 is equal to positive infinity. So you just want to check whether that is positive negative infinity or 0. Okay, so check answer 0, 8, positive infinity, negative infinity, negative infinity, negative infinity, and positive infinity. Example 4, find limit is polynomial as x approaches negative infinity. So for this type of the question, you don't have to substitute all every term. Just choose the highest power, the term with the highest power, the highest degree of the this one. So the highest degree, choose this one, choose this term, substitute. Okay, so number one, limit, okay, 7x power 5 as x tends to negative infinity, substitute. Okay, so here is actually x to the power odd number, so negative times 7, negative infinity. Okay, for number 2, okay, limit. Okay, choose this one, this term. This is the highest degree of the the highest degree of the PhD. Sibuk sangat ni. You all, sorry. Okay, I'm so not into. Okay. Okay. Example 4, limit is polynomial as x tends to negative infinity. So this one you don't have to substitute every term. Okay, for polynomial just choose the highest degree. So this one, okay, 5 is the highest. Okay, for the polynomial the degree is 5. Okay, and then okay, write down limit 7 x to power 5 as x tends to negative infinity. So this is x power 5, that is odd number. When substitute negative infinity here, that negative infinity times 7 is equal to negative infinity. Okay, for number 2, okay, limit this polynomial as x approaches negative infinity. So this is the degree of 8. And the highest power is, okay, so take this one. Limit, okay, negative 4 x power 8 as x tends to negative infinity. So now this one is substitute negative infinity to x, okay, power 8, it's even number, positive. So because of negative 4 is negative, so the answer is negative infinity. Okay? Limit at infinity for rational function. Okay, two cases. First case, when limit fx, rational fx over gx as x tends to infinity. Okay, for both fx and gx are polynomial. Polynomial. Okay, so divide each term by x with the highest power of denominator. So for this case, when poly over poly as x tends to infinity, so you have to divide each term by x with the highest degree power of denominator. That denominator, choose the highest power and divide each term up and down. Okay, when given that, in this case, limit this function over square root of dx as tends to infinity, or okay, square root of fx over gx as x tends to infinity. Either fx or gx is set function. Okay, how to solve that one? Divide each term by absolute value of x or modulus x. Okay, if in this case, okay, this is actually square root of nth root, right? nth root, if limit x tends to infinity, nth root of fx over gx. So how to solve that one? Just take all nth root all being outside, limit, okay, fx over gx as x tends to infinity. Solve this one first and then find nth root. Okay, this one is follow the first case. Example, find this one. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, first, for the first one, limit, okay, if you substitute, okay, this one is infinity. This one is also infinity. So infinity over infinity, this one in this case, okay, you have to use the highest power of denominator. So the highest power here for D, this is denominator, the highest power is, okay, 3. So divide each term by x3, x power 3. Okay, divide each term like this. Then simplify. Okay, simplify. Okay, this one is equal to 1 cancel 1 over x minus 3 over x cubed over 1 x over x squared plus 2 over x cubed. Then simplify. So how to simplify? Just is substitute 1 over infinity. 1 over infinity is equal to 0. 3 over infinity also 0. 1 also 0. 2 over x cubed also 0. So okay, once you substitute, okay, no more write the limit. Limit only when the function still has x variable. Okay, so answer is 2. Okay, the answer is 2. And for the second one, if you substitute negative infinity numerator get negative infinity and denominator get infinity. This one also in the pattern of, because that one is actually indeterminate form. Okay, then how to solve that one? You have to divide each term with the highest power of denominator. This is denominator. The highest power is here. Okay, here. So divide each term. Okay, by x. Okay, then simplify. Okay, this one x over x squared 1 over x. That is 3 minus 1 over x squared. Then this one is 1 over x is 0. 3 minus 1 over infinity is equal to 0. Then the answer is 0 over 3 minus 0. 0 over 3 is equal to C. Okay, for the third one, once you substitute, okay, this one is infinity positive and over infinity. This is indeterminate form. Poly over poly. So you have to divide with the highest power of denominator. Denominator is here. Okay, x squared is the highest power, so divide. Okay, divide is done by x squared. Then simple. Okay, there is x plus 2 over x squared. Then here is 3 minus 1 over x. Substitute. Okay, substitute here positive infinity. Here 2 over infinity is 0. 3, 0. So answer is this one. Infinity over something that is infinity. Still infinity. Okay. Then the fourth one, in this case, since all covered by a cube root of this one, so we can simplify or extend, modify like this. Root limit 3x plus 5 over 6x minus 8 x tends to positive infinity. So now, okay, settle everything inside the cube root. Okay, so here, this one, when you substitute infinity over infinity, this is indeterminate form. So you have to divide by x. So limit, okay, divide by x. 3 plus 5 over x, 6 minus 8 over x. This one all. Okay, and then this one is when you substitute 3 plus 5 over infinity, 0. This one, 0. Okay, and group substitute 3 plus 0 over 6 minus 0. And root of 1 over 2 or 1 over 2 power 1 over 3 or 1 over cube root of 2. Okay, so means you have to settle everything in the cube root. Okay? Why? Because of both covered by the same problem. Okay? H2 limit at infinity. Okay, when fx or gx, okay, fx poly, this one is c. Okay, this one is x tends to infinity. Okay, and then or up here third. Okay, this one poly tends to infinity. Okay. Either fx or gx is set function. Divide each term by modulus x, absolute value of x. Okay, so definition for absolute value of x. Okay, positive x when is x more or equal to 0. Negative x when x less than 0. Okay, and so this is definition for modulus x. Super third. X squared is equal to third x squared, and this one equal. So we can say that this third x squared is equal to this piecewise function. Okay. Then, okay, if we exchange, take this one. Okay, x is equal to plus x third x squared when x more than or equal to 0. Okay, and this one, okay, x is equal to negative third x squared when x less than 0. Okay, we're going to use this one. Okay, and okay, if x tends to positive infinity, x equals plus positive third x squared equals positive when x more than 0. If x tends to negative infinity, x equals negative third x squared, so when x less than 0. Okay, then for polynomial function we define as this one. Okay, and for this one is part polynomial function, the blue color for polynomial, this is xx. But for third function, okay, it depends on the case. When that one is x positive, change the third to positive third x squared. When x negative, change third to negative x third x squared. Okay. Find limit x tends to positive infinity poly third. This one tends to negative infinity poly, and this one infinity, okay, maybe negative positive, okay, and then this one poly and third, but so is here is x power 4. This one inside here x squared, the third is x power 4. Inside here you need to go twice, okay, and okay, and this one we're going to discuss on. Okay, first here check. Okay, let's say you substitute positive infinity here at infinity, and here set infinity also infinity. Infinity is over infinity in determinate form. Okay, and then you need to do something poly over poly, and then positive means that you have to divide set by positive x squared. Positive set x squared. And for poly, divide each term by x. Okay, and try to solve. Is equal to limit x tends to positive infinity x plus 1 x squared plus 1. So for polynomial, divide each term by x. For third, divide by x squared. So positive this one is actually positive. Okay, then simplify. Limit x tends to positive infinity, so 1 plus 1 over x. Okay, this one x squared plus 1 over x squared over x squared. Yes. Okay, bring this one inside here. Okay, then simplify. Limit x tends to positive infinity, 1 plus 1 over x. Third, 1 plus 1 over x squared. The next step is substitute. Okay, infinity. 1 over infinity is equal to 0. 1 over infinity also is equal to 0. Okay, so no more limit. After you substitute the value, we don't have to write the limit. Okay, just write the figure here, plus 0. 1 plus 0. 1 over third 1. Third 1 is equal to 1. And answer is 1. Okay, the answer is 1. Better for first example, part of example 6. Divide each term by x means that poly divide with x, third they divide by third x squared, then positive instead to the four. Okay, the second part. Okay, and check substitute negative infinity, and then here is infinity. It's also indeterminate form. Okay. And okay, means that poly third. Poly have to divide each term by x, and third divide each term by x squared. And then since this one is negative, also negative. Okay, and okay, let's solve this. What's that? Okay, divide each term by x for poly. Here also divide by set x squared, negative, because of this one is negative. Then simplify. Limit x tends to negative infinity, 1 plus 1 over x over negative x squared over x squared plus 1 over x squared. The next step, okay, simplify. X tends to negative infinity, 1 plus 1 over x over third negative 1 plus 1 over x squared. Then substitute negative infinity. Like 1 over infinity, negative infinity is equal to 0. 1 over infinity is equal to 0. So the answer is 1 plus 0 over negative, okay, 1 plus 0. Okay, so no more limit. You don't have to write limit. So 1 over negative third 1. Or negative 1. Okay, negative 1. Why? Because of third 1 is 1. So negative 1. Okay. If third x power 4 is equal actually x squared. So for this one, for polynomial divide by x squared, and for third divide by x power 4. Or if you divide the poly by x and divide the third by third x squared, you have to do twice. Okay, and then you divide all by x squared and third x power 4, or here. Okay, so for the yellow one, you need to do twice. Okay, for this one, just once only. Okay, and limit this one. Okay, let's say you want to divide by x. Just follow the rule. Poly or third. You have to do twice. Why? Because of x power 4. Okay? Okay, so now substitute infinity over infinity in determinate form, only over third, and x tends to infinity. You have to do, you have to divide only by x and third by third x squared. Okay? And limit x tends to infinity, x over x plus 1 over x, okay, x power 4 plus 1 over x. Okay, the next step, limit x tends to infinity, 1 plus 1 over x, bring here inside the third, you get this one is power 4 over x squared, that x squared plus 1 over x squared. Okay, and then actually if you substitute the value here, you substitute, let's say here, you get actually 1 plus 0, so it's infinity plus 0. So 1 over infinity is equal to 0. Okay, but try again, we proceed for this one. Okay, you get the answer right. You can stop until this step, right? Suppose you can stop until this one. Okay, 0, answer is 0. But it's okay, just want to show you this one is, you want to get rid of x squared. Okay, continue. Limit as x tends to infinity, 1 over x. Okay, 1 over x plus 1 over x squared. Okay, over, okay, this one is x squared over x squared 1. Okay, 1 over x power 4. Okay. Then, okay, substitute here, get 0, 1 over infinity 0 plus 1 over infinity 0 over 1 plus 0. Answer is 0 over 1, that is 0. 0. Okay, here actually you substitute, still get the same one. 0. 0 to infinity 0. Okay? Okay, so either you do, okay, follow the procedure, divide by x, divide by this one, divide by x squared. Okay, you have to do twice, or if you get the answer, just stop. Okay, or divide by x squared for this, divide by x power 4. Okay, you get the same answer. Here, if you do the first part, you cannot get answer. You need to proceed. Okay. Then in example 7, find this one. Okay, then here if you substitute this one, get positive and positive infinity, why square root always positive, minus negative infinity. So this one is positive infinity minus plus, answer plus, confirm positive infinity for this part. Okay, positive infinity, why? Because of this one, under square root, square root produce positive, minus infinity positive. So here you can see 0, why? We don't know the exact number. Okay, we don't know which one bigger, so we cannot say this is 0. This is under indeterminate form. Okay, so that to solve example 7. Okay, this one settle, no problem, because of positive infinity confirm, positive square root, minus, positive, or positive infinity. For part 2, okay, Then if you substitute negative infinity positive minus infinity, we know this undeterminate form, so you need to do something times its conjugate. And this is consider conjugate for this conjugate plus so minus plus expand numerator, this one expand the conjugate over this one. Then okay, try to divide. Okay, divide is true. Let's say if you substitute infinity over infinity, also indeterminate form. Okay, and okay, this one is actually cancel, huh? So cancel. Okay, like again, limit x approaches infinity 3x over x squared plus 3x plus x. Okay, it's easier. So divide each term, this is poly third. Okay, it's equal to limit x tends to infinity 3x by x third x squared plus 3x plus x. So divide by x poly over third x squared, consider as greater than positive. Okay, and simplify limit x tends to infinity 3, this one is bring inside that 1 plus 3 over x, bring one inside x squared over x squared 1 plus 3x over x squared 3 over x plus 1. Okay, continue here, is equal to 3 over 1 plus 0 plus 1. And then so it is substitute infinity 3 over infinity 0. So then simplify 3 set 1 is 1 plus 1 and it's equal to 3 over 3. Answer is 3 over 3. Okay. Conclusion, limit at infinite case 1, okay, for case 1. Okay. Case 1, if fx gx poly over poly, okay, when x tends to infinity, okay, poly over poly, and in the term form case, okay, divide term, okay, with the highest power of denominator. Okay, settle. For case 2, when poly over third or third over poly, okay, poly over third or third over poly, okay, divide each term by modulus x. So this one also divide to two cases, first and okay, if x approaches or tends to positive infinity, okay, but third you have to divide positive third x squared. For x tends to negative infinity, okay, third you have to divide with the negative third x squared. And for poly here, you just need to divide by x only.